Back in the book segment tonight, South Korean guy who calls himself Psy has put out a video that has been viewed more than 800 million times on the net. That's a record. So you would think the video must be very, very special. Well, here it is.
Oppan Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style.
Joining us now from Boston to explain the madness, psychiatrist Dr. Keith Ablow. All right, so the guy, remember the pony? He's just doing the pony. I mean, you know.
The pony.
The pony. That's what he's doing. And he's dumping up and down. And 800 views of this? What's going on?
Well, look, there will be those who dismiss this as having no meaning, just a good beat and a lot of fun. I won't be one of those dismissing it, because when you approach a billion views on YouTube and surpass Justin Bieber, perhaps you're tapping into something. And I think what this fellow's tapping into is, in fact, this Psy, P-S-Y, is tapping into the fact that people don't want any meaning right now. Music, the most popular music, apparently, is that without intelligible words, to some extent, that simply conveys you to a distant place, beat-wise, doesn't try to convince you of anything. That doesn't try to raise your emotions. It just is sort of like a drug. And that seems to be what most people seem to want right now. Not reality, not feeling, not meaning.
All right. So it means nothing, but it's got a nice upbeat to it, and you can do the pony and ride around.
I think the meaning is that it has no meaning. It is the son of Facebook, if you will. The false face that so many people now put on their lives, the lack of insight, if you will, is reflected in this person's popularity. Elvis Presley didn't invent sexuality, but he tapped into the growing sexuality
culture. But wait. Elvis Presley could sing. He had a good voice. His songs had words. Are you lonesome?
Yes.
Okay. All right. He put on a show. This is a little fat guy from Yangyang or someplace, Seoul.
Wearing sunglasses.
Whatever. And he's jumping up and down. There's no comparison between Psy and, you know, there are like 16 guys named Psy on Long Island that I can tell you about. They don't look like him. All right? So there's no... And the phenomenon, I mean, you can understand Presley, the Beatles, the Rolling Stones, even Justin Bieber. I got all, right? But this is something more. But I think you may be onto something, because this is internet driven. And it looks to me like the internet is just a place where people want some kind of numb themselves to some degree.
Exactly right. It's internet driven. It's international. It's an incredible success in dozens of countries. Why? Because globally, folks are losing their center. They want not to be reminded of what they think and feel, but more conveyed away from it. You know what? I had a little kid's book I wrote. I sent it out to a few publishers, and they bemoaned the fact. They said, gee, it seems like it has a message. I said, well, yeah, it's about empowerment. Well, books about messages right now aren't selling.
So you want kids. Wimpy kid books. You want that kind of stuff, just pure escapism.
Wimpy kid books, Olivia, look at the cute pig, the little pig likes red shoes. Trying to tell them about courage, that's not going to be purchased by the great masses who now want not to be tapped on the heartstrings, if you will, but simply to be pushed toward a good beat that kind of buries them in music.
Last question. I don't see anything wrong with this. You know, if you want to waste your time looking at this, or you like the beat, I don't think anything wrong with that. You might lose a few pounds jumping up and down like a pony. That might help out, you know? So I don't see anything wrong with this. Is there anything wrong with it?
Well, look, is there anything wrong with it? I guess I'd say this. To the extent that you revel in things that don't speak to you, that you use something to transport you away from real thought and deep feeling, yeah, there's something wrong with it.
Right, so if you watch this like 7 times a day, that might not be good. So you watch it once.
It's the same as getting high in miniature.
I don't think
it's a little bit.
It's
a drug.
So. Now, once you alter your consciousness with substance, then it's a whole different ballgame. This, I think, is relatively harmless.
More subtle.
Unless you're walking into a job interview like this with dark glasses on, then that's going to hurt. All right, doctor, thanks very much. Fact or tip of the day, I need your help. The tip, 60 seconds away.